the sunshine in God's house. We just thank you for just coming out. And we just gonna give God all the praise. Celebrating our 129th church anniversary. A mighty long time. We ain't gonna prolong this. We're gonna get ready to get started with our divorce here. We're gonna do a song and a prayer, and we'll turn it over to our worship leader. When all God's children get together, oh, what a time, what a time, oh, what a time. We gonna sit around by the banks of the river. Oh, what a time, what a time, oh, what a time.
Father God in heaven, once more and again, we call on your holy name. But this time, God, we're coming to you in celebration of 129 years of down here trying to get it right. It's an anniversary. It's a new anniversary. It's 129 years. We're looking back. And we seeing where we came from and how much we know now that we didn't know back then. 129 years of trying to serve you in the right way. And we asking right now that you would just come inside these great chapel walls. We ask that you bring the Holy Ghost with you and let everything that be said, every word that's read, every voice that's heard. God, we ask that you just send down blessings. We ask that you send down guidance. Because God, we need you. We're in a time now that we can look around and we can say, we really need something and someone. Somebody that's over each and everything in our lives. Thank you for the air we breathe. Thank you for this service, this afternoon service. Some of your followers, so devoted followers, sit right here to learn more about you. Father God, we put aside all the other things that we could have been doing to do something that's so very much needed, and that's to learn more and more about you. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, for being God and God all by yourself, knowing that you have a blessing for each and every one of us in due time, knowing that all blessings aren't the blessings that you said, oh God, that was good. Some of the blessings are blessings that challenged you. And God, we ask that you give us the strength. We ask that you teach us how to accept all blessings, whether good or bad, to accept all blessings, knowing that you are in charge of each and every one of our lives. So we ask that you just come down. Spend just a little time with us on our 129th anniversary. We want to give you all the praises. We want to sing loud and very clear. We want every instrument to just glorify you. We want to praise your holy name. We want to spend another 129 years praising your name, serving a God that we know are in control of all things. Thank you so very much for Grace Chapel. Thank you for the leaders of Grace Chapel. Thank you for the families of Grace Chapel. Thank you for the visiting churches. Let's go help us celebrate. And we just ask our Heavenly Father, if you'll just come right here. Come right here in these walls. And bless these walls. Anoint these walls. And what we can send all the praises and give you all the praises and thanks. We ask this in your Son, Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Now we're going to turn it over to the hands of Brother.
Let's say that when they first found this church 129 years ago, how happy they was to have a church beginning. Because one day, soon and very soon, we're going to be able to praise God from whom we never seen.
Amen.
That's what Revelation says. So let us praise God today on this church anniversary.
Amen.
Doxology, praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Oh Lord, our God, how excellent is thy name.
Yes, Lord.
Thy holy name in all the earth. We thank you, Lord, for Grace Chapel, AME Church. We're down here, Lord, celebrating 129 years of service to uplift your holy and righteous name. Bless our theme, dear Jesus, working through it all with God's help. For we know, Lord, with your help, all things are possible. Please teach us the scripture, Lord, as you taught Moses in Exodus 19, verse 21. You said, charge the people, lest they break through unto the Lord to gaze. We need to see you, Lord Jesus. We need to look to you, Lord Jesus. And many of them perish. We are perishing now, Lord Jesus. And we ask that you continue to watch over us. Lord, we have to look to you. Not President Trump. Not anyone in this world, Lord, but you. We see those perishing now, Lord. Hurricanes, earthquakes, violence, sickness. Let us look to you. For only you can help us work through our trials and tribulations. Lord, bless all who are bereaved and heavy laden. Heal those who don't even know they're sick. Protect us, Jesus, from hurt, harm, and danger. Be with us in a dying hour. You said in your word, I'll be with you always. Even until the ends of the age. Thank you, Father, for blessing me.
Thank you.
Thank you for the soldiers who came before us. Lead us, Lord, into the path of righteousness. Forgive us of our sins and lead us not into temptation. We ask that you anoint our talents so that you have so graciously given us so that we may ever give the praise and honor. We love you, and we thank you, and we praise you. These things we ask in your name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.
The Lord has been good to me. The Lord has been good to me. Of the wicked. Lazy hands make a man poor, but the diligent hands bring wealth. He who gathers crops in the summer is a wise son, but he who sleeps during the harvest is a disgraceful son. Blessings crown the head of the righteous, but violence overwhelms the mouth of the wicked. The memory of the righteous will be a blessing, but the name of the wicked will not. The wise in heart accept command, but a chattering fool comes to ruin. The man of integrity walks securely, but he who takes crooked paths will be found out. He who winks maliciously causes grief, and a chattering fool comes to ruin. The mouth of the righteous is a foundation of life, but violence overwhelms the mouth of the wicked.
Amen. 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 Thank you, Brother Garland, for that wonderful scripture. And now we have the weapon by Sister Pamela Pitts.
Amen.
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 Good afternoon, church. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I greet you in Jesus' joy. Amen. On behalf of our shepherd, Pastor Charlie Crane Stembridge, and First Lady Sharon Stembridge, and our second shepherd, Pastor Hill and Sister Hill, I come to tell you, welcome into this place.
Amen. church history. My sister Josephine B. Bryant.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Today we celebrate our celebration today, rather. It's twofold. We're celebrating 129 years of documented history. We know that the church is older than 129 years, but we can only find documentation for 129 years. The second reason we are celebrating today is that our pastor's birthday. So before I read the history, let's all sing happy birthday to this wonderful man. Clark, W.H. Horton, N.S. Pitts, R.B. Banks, D.M. Morton, M.D.A., Brother Rick Straw, Brother Russell, Brother Gaither, and Brother Crutchfield. The presiding elder was the Reverend H.D. Canty, and the pastor was the Reverend W.C. Canty. The church was rebuilt in 1916, and for the next 40 years, the church and the school became a beacon of light for the Mount Pleasant and Brickstone community. Serving as pastors were the Reverend Scarborough, the Reverend Maddox, and the Reverend C.O. Adams. Presiding elders were the Reverend Carter, the Reverend L.J. Jones, and the bishops were Bishop Bearden and Bishop Hildebrand. Leadership during those years, coming into the 21st century, were the Cheney, Graham, Glassberg, Sappho, Wynn, Strong, Banks, Simon, Carroll, Pitts, Smith, Reed, and Williams family. The next 20 years during the Civil Rights era, the church continued to be a pivotal force in the community, leading boys and girls, men and women to Christ. The pastors were the Reverends Myrie, Adams, E.L. Harper, who served here at Grace Chapel and Carver for 22 years, and the Reverend Richard Mitchell. Presiding elders were the Reverend Dr. Flanagan, Reverend Carter, Reverend Daniel Jacobs, and Scarborough. After the death of Reverend Carver in 1979, the Reverend W.R. Wicks Jr. was appointed to Grace Chapel. It was during his tenure that the church became active in all levels of the church. The presiding elder at that time was Reverend T.N. Mincy. From 1982 to 1984, the Reverend Jimmy Collier served as pastor. 1984 to 1987, the Reverend Charles Wells Jr. was appointed. And in 1987, the Board of Stewards and Trustees presented a resolution to Presiding Elder S.W. Wicker requesting permission to dissolve the Sister Wicker Carver Chapel and become a station church. Other pastors during this particular period were the Reverend Terrence Gray, Lewis Logan, Nicolene Durham, who became the first female pastor in the life of this church, Reverend Regina Jacobs, Reverend Michael Jones, and Reverend Joseph Como. 2001 to 2017, God in his divine wisdom, and with the stroke of the pen in Bishop Cummings' hand, the Reverend Charlie Frank Stembridge Sr. and family came to us at a time when we needed a spiritual rebirth. His accomplishments in the past 17 years are too numerous to cite today. However, he constantly reminds us that where there's a will, there's a way. And that way is God's way. He tells us we must trust God. We must commit ourselves. But most of all, we must study God's word to show ourselves approved. Our forefathers and mothers left us a living legacy. And as we celebrate 129 years of that legacy today, on this Christian journey, it is our pledge to continue to be fishers of lost souls and kingdom building. Our history.
We thank Sister Brown for that much, much more. Like she said, she did them bits and pieces, but she did a very efficient job. Yeah. We now have the anniversary litany, our sister, Mildred Hill. We all stand.
Good evening, God's children. Today, we'd like you to exercise your voice with me in reading the church litany. Let us read together. As I read the light print, you will read the dark print. Dear Lord, thank you for drawing us as a congregation to you to become part of your church.
Thank you for our ancestors and those who listen to your voice and will continue to do your call to organize this congregation for your purposes.
Help us teach your young your ways and their history so they will know who you are and who they can be.
Inspire us with the vision of the future and use that vision to direct the path of this congregation.
Help us lean not on our own understanding, but to lean on every promise of your word.
Grant us the authority to conquer all our enemies and fill us with the desire to love each other.
Lord, please protect us from all evil, from those spirits that seek to destroy the peace you have given us.
May your spirit continue to be in
teach us to know your voice and give the courage to obey it altogether.
Lord, please continue to provide the church with the light of the world. Amen.
Thank you, Sister Hill, for that beautiful litany. We will now have the offering, anniversary reports, and offer of prayer. Thanks. Stewards, will you please come in to your duty along with the ushers?
Lord, we come saying thank you, O Lord. Thank you for being able to give back this little portion that you allowed us to have. Lord, we ask that you bless this offering, and Father, see, do as you see favorable, Lord, and we know that it will be worked out accordingly. We pray that it save a soul, keep church doors open, Lord, Father, so we can multiply and add to your kingdom. Lord, bless each and every one here under the sound of my little weak voice. Bless us and keep not only us, but our families and friends also. Lord, all we got to do, keep on trusting you and know everything will be all right. We ask all these things, Heavenly Father, in your precious Son, Jesus' name.
Amen. It's now time for me to get back in my regular seat on the audience. And I thank everyone for their participation on this program as far as I was concerned. Again, now we turn it over to the hands of the pastor, Reverend Charlie Frank Stenridge.
Amen.
Bring us down to this far. Now it's time for me to present our speaker for today. You know, sometimes it's hard to present a speaker, sometimes it's easy. Today it's real easy because the one I'm going to present today, he's known by about everybody. He goes everywhere. You know, some speakers or some preachers, they just go to the same church and same route back home. And that's what I'm about to present today. The Reverend Hill, our own, the Reverend Flagler, any other minister, evangelist, was in our figure today because he's already known. I was just sitting in my office before I even thought about presenting him, and somebody said they saw him down here at a lawnmower shop. So he not only go to church, but he go out and play there as well. Our figure today, first thing he did as he grew up was to make himself and his parents happy by finishing high school.
Amen.
As he finished school, you find that he went to the United States Marine Corps and served his time. And when he came back home, I like the nickname he did, he went to the workplace because everybody needs to work a job. While working the job, he had an itch. Had a hunch.
Come on.
Right. Someone on the inside, he known him that he had a higher calling.
Yeah.
Had another job waiting to be done.
Yes.
Waiting to be filled. So he went on and then decided whether to do something for the education. Went to several schools and got several degrees, and when the Lord called him to preach, he was ready to go. I looked on his resume and saw that he had pastored several churches. And as he was pastor, he wasn't too busy to see or work for the comfort.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I had one main job that I loved for 20 some years in the comfort. I consider myself the boss. And by being the boss, I see other preachers do things, and so many of them don't do nothing. But not the one I'm going to present.
Right.
He just don't let one job hold him down. Every time I go to the conference, I got to find out and figure out where he is and what he's doing. But he's busy working for the Lord.
Amen.
Married, 2 children, 4 grand, and that's a proud right there. I stop now. Don't have to say too many more because you already know him.
Amen.
Good friend of mine, and anybody meet, I have a speaker today, you can't help but to be his friend.
Amen.
He don't meet no strangers.
Yeah.
Sometimes he just search for friends. Let's go. Let me see what this guy's brother doing. So he always trying to reach out of here. So St. Paul, Butler on the north side of Covington, y'all have a fine pastor.
Amen.
My brother, I go a step further than probably say my neighbor.
Right.
We live in the same city. Good little way, but we don't mind coming down the road to our church.
Amen.
Listening to the choir sing this May of course, let me hurry up and get out of the way. After they come again, The next boy, he actually come with whatever he sings, all right with me. Would be the pastor of St. Paul after Methodist Episcopal Church, Cupton, Georgia, the Reverend Steve.
Amen.
You ain't y'all give a hand next time. Thank you.
Amen. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. There are days I get caught up in one of them. Today is one of them. Graves, I thank you for allowing us to be here with you for your anniversary of 129 years. Whether y'all know it or not, y'all pastor is one of the greatest preachers in the Atlanta. He's one of those preachers that get great respect from everybody. And when he say he the boss, he the boss. There are certain preachers don't want to see him coming, doing conference, because they know the bishop done sent for him. That's right. They know the bishop, and they see it coming, they just drop their head. But Sister Stemridge, thank you. My wife is not here, and she wanted me to tell you she would have been here, but she was asked to be somewhere else. I'm always blessed to be in Reverend Stemridge's company, and I've shared this once before when I was pastoring on the corner of Lakewood and Pryor, and that was some days that it was time to throw in the towel. You know, you wanted to lay hands on folks and not like God wanted you. You'll get that going, huh? But God always had a way of sending just what you need. Now, if you don't believe God exists, when you at your worst and somebody show up and speak a word of encouragement, nobody but God. And this preacher used to make it his point to stop by just out of the blue. Looked like every time he showed up, Sister Flaggy, it was the time for me to have that. And I would pour out my heart, and he never throwed it back at me, never told nobody. To this day, he never said a word about the day he got crying on the show. And then he had the nerve to call me his friend. That's good enough in itself. Graves, thank y'all so much for your kind hospitality. St. Paul, you know I love you. We're not putting on a show. We don't never go anywhere for show. When we started in this role of ministry, I told them, and they still practice this, we go to help and we go to bless you and we go to lift up the name of the Lord. We don't do it for show. We come to minister in music. Somebody ought to say amen. Now, because you've been so sweet and you're here at 3 o'clock, I got one little one thing I do try to keep. If you kind enough and you got enough courage and enough faith to come back at 3 o'clock, I got enough sense to only keep you here to 9 o'clock tonight. Somebody just smile on that and say, you might be serious. No. If you come, we promise, if you come, hour 15, hour 20 max, amen? And we can have a good time, because it don't take God long to show up, and so if you say amen, if you don't look too puzzled, we won't be here too long. Amen? Again, let me thank these musicians, all the musicians. Come on, give God some praise. While I'm settling down, Ephesians, the fourth chapter. Church anniversary. That's a good thing. There's a nugget of wisdom tucked away in this fourth chapter. You can find it in that 16th verse, but actually this whole chapter is dealing with what is the church. And for the church to have been in existence, this church, for 129 years. I hope to open your eyes to something that makes you understand God been with you all along. So you had some good days.
Good days.
And I know you had some bad days. But watch. Because I know God has been with you for 129 years. Your good days. You got it. If y'all help me, I won't trouble you long. It's tucked. It's tucked right in here in that 16th verse. Watch. If you got it, say amen. I want you to go home and study it. And it simply says, and I'm from him, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love. I watch. God is what?
Love.
Oh, y'all a little slow. Y'all a little slow. The slower you are, the longer we gonna be. God is what?
Love.
Oh, oh. They heard me speed it up. God is love, as each part does his work. Now, if you will let me just quickly explain this, Rem Hill, Rem Flagey, thank y'all. Falcons ain't playing, so we ain't got to rush home to watch them. If you let me explain this just a little bit, I won't trouble you long. Now, it's prayer time. It's prayer time. Our God and our Father, we humble ourselves before your great presence. We come this evening with thanksgiving on our heart, praises on our lips, our hands lifted up to you, because we know you are God. God, we realize and understand that you sit high and you look low, that you rule and you super rule, because heaven is your throne and earth is your footstool. And God, we are your handiwork. And God, here we are this afternoon, just to say thank you. You've allowed ourselves to call ourselves a church called Grace Chapel for 129 years. And here we are this evening. Just to say thank you. God, many have started this route. Some made it 6 months. Some made it 3 or 4 years. Some closed up 2 weeks after they opened. But here we are, God, 129 years. To us. And we just want to say thank you. Now God, if you don't mind, keep on blessing us the way you see fit. Help us to understand there are going to be some mega churches, there are going to be some small churches, but you got Graves Chapel tucked right there in the middle. Keep on using us to be a light in this community. Keep on causing us to come Sunday after Sunday, calling on your name. Keep on keeping on. Right here. In Jesus' name. Now, God, when we show up, you come on and show out. We know we meet you in the morning when we wake up. We know we meet you at school when we get there. We meet you on our job. But, God, when we come to Grace Chapel, you show up. And you show out for another 129 years. We ask this individually and collectively, and all the saints agree by saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. The church.
Church.
Now watch. When the church started, God put the, come on, Ursus, you can adjust yourself. I'm going to do this just a little bit different. When the church started, God made sure that the church would survive whether we had this building or not.
Okay.
Now watch. When he built the church, he put the church where? Somebody know that. He put the church in us. So therefore, he said, we'll never neglect the gathering of yourselves together. So whenever you got together, whether it was in the Brush Harbor, down by the river, let's go down. Y'all know that song? By the river. Now, either you got together at the river and you got under the tree, you had the church.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
You you had the church choir. Because where two or three gathered together in his name, he was in the midst. So you had the church. So therefore, when he designed the church, he made sure the church would have longevity as long as we did what he had asked us to do. You know what that is? He said we got to love one another. Now, you cannot call yourself a child of God. You can't call yourself a Christian and then call yourself a church member if you can't love one another. Coach, it ain't gonna be long. I'm gonna exhort this and we're gonna get up out of here. Watch. He made it plain. How can you love God whom you've never seen? And you can't even love this brother sitting next to you. Ain't gonna meddle. Ain't gonna meddle. But from my vantage point, there are days I see people walk into church and they do like this. And then they'll go to the other side. They don't do that at Graves Chapel. I've seen that. That ain't at St. Paul either, brother.
Go ahead, preacher.
I pray I ain't saw that. But if you say you are a child of God, amen, somebody, and you say that you got the church in you, then you got to love everybody. That means you can't pick and choose. You got to love
everybody.
Now Jesus made that very simple. Watch, I'm going somewhere. He said, love ye one another as I
love you.
So therefore, he made it plain and made it possible for the church to have longevity.
Yes, sir.
And then he went a step further and said, neglect not the gathering of yourselves together.
Yeah.
Now Moses came along and they had a tent. And the tent was because they had to move every so often. So whenever they got where they were going, they put up the tent.
Yeah.
But guess what? They had church.
Yeah.
And when it was time to move on, they took the tent down, put it back on the camel, and it went somewhere else.
Yeah.
But when they got where they were going, they would take the tent down, put up the tent, and they would have what?
Church.
But 129 years ago, God spoke to somebody here at Graves Chapel and said, I want you to be in one place. Watch. You could have been here 2 years, except somebody understood we got to work through our difficulties. Now that's a story I ain't gonna tell, but maybe two stories. There's a story of a young man that got married with the apple of his eye, and after he married her, he realized something wasn't quite right. Every day she yakety-yak. And he heard that part. He said, for better, for worse, until death do us part. So he would put up with it, and after a while, over the years, he had gotten tired. He would just go out in the field and plow. Him and his old mule, and the mule tended to understand that something wasn't right because he out plowing in the wintertime and you don't plow in the wintertime. The mule knew something wasn't right. So one day the wife didn't fix his lunch before he went to the fields, and she brought the lunch to the fields to him. And as she was coming, it was yakety-yak. She was nagging. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about. Yakety-yakety-yak. And she was standing there as he was sitting under the tree, and the old mule just got to shaking his head, and the bees was buzzing. He said, and he kicked. Hit her dead in the back of the head. Killed her, as they say, graveyard dead. Time of the funeral. Time of the funeral. The pastor had given the eulogy, but he noticed something strange. The brother had been married over 40 years, and when ladies would come by, he would smile and shake his head. But when the men came by, he would frown and shake his head. No. The ladies come by, he would smile and just agree with them, and then when the men, he'd shake his head no. So after it was all over, the pastor couldn't wait to get to him and figure out, well, what was going on? One minute you were smiling and the next minute you had an attitude. He said, well, when the ladies came by, they would compliment my wife and her casket on the dress she was wearing, how pretty it was, and how the hat she had on looked, and how nice and sweet she was. But when the men came by, they wanted to buy my mule. I stop by to tell you everything will be all right. And if you continue to let God lead you, when you get to the house of prayer, you're going to find one thing. The church cannot exist. Watch. If you got church, it says C-H, U-R-C-H. If you take the U-R out of church, all you got is C-H, C-H. What's missing? You are. You are. If you can't from the church. So we ought to be building the church together in love. And as long as we build the church together in love, I declare God will show up every time. And when God shows up, show out. You may be down in your finances, but God will make a way out of no way. If you show up, God will show out. You may be sick in your body, God has a way of bringing a healing hand to the church. I'm getting ready to leave you now. There's a story found over in Nehemiah. Nehemiah had a good job serving the king as his cupbearer. And all he had to do was taste the food. Now anybody in their right mind wasn't about to kill Nehemiah, because he was the buffer between the king and the baker. He was the buffer between the king and the butcher. He was the buffer between the king and the farmers. So Nehemiah had it good, y'all. But one day, the Lord's servant stopped by and told Nehemiah, the Lord needs you to build his church. Can't you see him now going back down to Jerusalem? Heather had already fixed the church, and Nehemiah had to build a wall. They had to get busy, didn't have time for grumbling, didn't have time for complaining. Can't you see him now? One on the wall, helping another up the wall. On the wall together, building the wall up. And that's what we got to do. Learn how to help one another up on the wall. And as long as we're on the wall, we may as well work till the day is done. Work as long as. Somebody stayed on the wall. Somebody did a work when they didn't feel like working. Somebody sacrificed when they didn't have it to give. But they had a mind to build the Lord. I declare, if you keep your hand in the Lord's hand, then everything will work out. All right. Told you I wasn't going to worry you long. If you build the church in love, if you work together in love, if you walk together in love, God has a way of blessing you in love. Amen. 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 Won't you stand? Raymond, you started me down a road. Now I deliberately tried not to sing, but God has smiled on me. If you look back, Sister Josephine, since you've been here, it's been a good day. It's been a good day. Come on, Rosette. It was a good day. The old saints rolled off the pitcher, but God always brings them. Saint to take their place. What? 17 years. You know how hard it is? One of the rarities is to see a preacher stay someplace more than five. But to be a 17, come on. Come on. God, look, there's peace in the house. There's love in the house. God. God, we stand before you as your called and elected officers, those we put in office and those we knew you had told us to pick and put in place. So God, right now, continue to endow them, give them wisdom and knowledge. Come on, God, anoint them that they may walk worthy. Anoint them that they may have wisdom to help lead your people from one degree of grace to another. Anoint them so that when troubles rise, they stand in the gap. Anoint them so no matter what comes up, they got the strength, the fortitude to stand on your word, because God, you didn't bring them this far just to let them fall now. God, you know what? We can't beat you giving, so the more they give, the more you give to them. Bless them to be a blessing. Not only the Graves Chapel, but bless them to be a blessing in their homes. Not only in their homes, but bless them to be a blessing on their jobs. And then, God, allow them to be that light that causes individuals to wonder and understand that, hey, something different about them. Use them, God. You use them, God. And do it in Jesus' name. Continue to bless this church for the greatness you've already placed here. And make them part of that greatness. Have your way. Come on, God, have your way. We don't want to get in the way of anything you want to do. Have your way. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Stegall, for the wonderful sermon. Yes. Thank you, Mel White. Yes. Yes. We're gonna let Grace Chapel's male choir sing off with St. Paul's being white. They ask you anything, play dumb. You should have been here, you weren't here, and you can just wonder what went on. Okay? But we want to thank you. We want to thank you for the food, for your attendance this morning, and your attendance this afternoon. But most of all, we want to thank you for that sacrifice that you made so that we could meet our obligations financially.
Amen.
That's the best birthday gift that this pastor could have gotten. Because I know Miss Stembridge, you know, has cooked this big dinner and everything for him. Then she's gonna take him out. And she's gonna buy him a new suit to go with that tie James gave him. She's going to fix him up. But I think today has been the best birthday gift he could have gotten. For all the members again, we prayed like the pastor told us to do. We committed ourselves like the pastor told us to do. We believed and we had faith, and God granted our wish. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart on behalf of Teresa, who had to leave. But I thank you so much. Those that worked in the kitchen, thank you so much. At this time, Pastor Stembridge will have the parting words along with the dynamic speaker, the storyteller.
Everybody say amen.
Amen.
I'll be brief in my remarks. I'm so happy, so grateful to be this afternoon for everything you have done. But before I go to the further, Ms. Stembridge, we are staying and introduce the spouses.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you, Paul, for coming to share with us tonight. I want to
thank you for
Again, thank you so much. Me, of course, I didn't know y'all, all y'all faces, y'all just smiling, sound of you. But Warren missing back now, I didn't see my buddy, your brother, Warren, who I call Travel. Who he is?
He travels.
He travels.
He travels.
God bless you all. Again, thank you so much. Wait, don't finish.
Praise Chapel, thank you. Let me thank St. Paul. St. Paul, just wave your hand. Come on, all St. Paul. Again, I thank this male chorus. They are faithful. Grace Chapel, you know, anytime y'all need us, call us.
We will.
And we try to make sure we have some type of representation here. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Now, Carla, y'all got our child over there. Y'all still taking care of him. Y'all know that's our child.
Amen.
That's our child. Carla, we thank you because y'all have taken great care of us. Brother Maddox, you did an awesome job.
Yes,
you did an awesome job. And since you did your job, I'm gonna do the same thing. Come on, so everybody.
Let the church.
Come on, everybody.